Hi there guys, welcome back. Googly's been a part of our daily lives since a while, so why not tweak ourselves a little bit to make the maximum use of it? Today we are going to presenting you the 6 ways to master your Google search for daily life. The tricks or methods we are using on this video, both applicable to computers to handheld devices. Before we starting, I suggest you to hit that subscribe button to get more tips in future. Search by voice. This is probably the best, easy and hassle-free way to search something on Google. Just click on the microphone button on the right end of the search box and say your query, for example, Himalayas.
According to Wikipedia, the Himalayas or Himalaya form a mountain range in Asia separating the plains of the Indian subcontinent from the Tibetan Plateau.
See, we know searching something by saying is easy compared to typing or other input methods. But for voice searches, you have an extra advantage over the other inputs. Yes, the instant voice response from Google, like we just heard a couple of seconds ago, which describes the result in a short and catchy way, so it's definitely worth it. Incognito. The incognito mode in our Google Sound Chrome browser will give us a partially private way to search the web. Just go to the Customize and Control at the upper right hand corner of your Chrome browser and choose New Incognito window from here. Now search anything you want privately. It will hide your browsing history, cookies and all kind of stuff from others are using the same device. As well as, please remember, it's not a complete private way to surf web. Your internet activities and behaviors can be still be recorded by your ISP, and the site you have visited will keep a record of your stay as well. Search using images. This particular method will allow you to search with any image on Google Image. Let me give you an example. Once you're on Google Image, click on this camera icon and here you can search the image by the image URL. You can manually upload the image or you can do it my way, which is drag and drop the image from your computer and it will search. Usually you will get a result like this, which will show you some similar images and in most cases even the accurate or related information about your image. So you may definitely find something about the image. Google.com. No more logged into a country-specific Google homepage. We all know Google.com is a global standard version of Google search, even though we always get redirected to a country-specific Google pages, like Google.com.in, Google.com.uk and so on and so on. We know Google doing this to make our search results a little more local to give us more control over the result in our local area. But it is not the case most of the time because we know Google.com got a better search result if you prefer a global standard. Well, no worries, I got something for you. Instead of searching Google.com and end up on country-specific pages, you can search Google.com/NCR. This will definitely help you stay in Google.com. If you want, you can change your browser home button in settings to Google.com/NCR and get access to Google.com directly anytime you want. Location-specified queries. This would allow you to make searches for a specific location, and it will stop Google's default behavior to provide result by tracking your location using your IP address. For example, if you normally search for food corners or food joints, it will give you the localized result, but if you want to check out some other place other than your location, you can use this trick. Just try searching food corners or whatever your query is, followed by the pin code or city name you wish, and it will bring you the result you're looking for. Make private searches. Have you heard about startpage.com? Well, it is a solution for a complete private browsing experience. Using their services, you are free from ISP, IP, Google or website tracking. This is not a first-party solution, but it's Google enhanced, as they say. It looks similar to a traditional Google homepage, but when you search something, it goes nowhere, meaning you're cut off from the rest of the internet. To be more clear, once you search for something with startpage, they remove all identifying information from your query and submit it anonymously to any external source they query. And they get the result and return them to you in total privacy. Your IP address is never recorded, your visit is not logged, and no tracking cookies are placed on your browser. May results a completely private web surfing experience. That's all for today, time to wind up. But we know there are more Google tricks that helps you in daily life, so I assume there will be a second part as well. And you can help us with that. Just comment your tricks or method which is helpful to the subject. We would like to feature them on our new videos. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, share and subscribe. We appreciate it.